Today we are going to look at Actix, a high-performance framework for building web applications in Rust. This might be interesting both if you are just starting with Rust or if you are an experienced developer exploring some web capabilities in Rust. Actix is known for its speed and efficiency. It consistently ranks as one of the fastest frameworks out there. It's asynchronous by default, which means it can handle many requests at once, making it suitable for applications that need to be responsive under load. Actix also provides control over concurrency, which can be helpful for developers needing fine-tuned performance. In this video, we will see a simple hello world with just three routes and we'll just test them. The goal is just to understand the basic syntax and see if we like it or not. Let's dive in. Let's create a new Rust project, cargo new, Actix hello world. Let's step into the directory. Let's open the IDE. Let's open cargo.toml and we need just one dependency, Actix Web 4. Let's open the main.rs file. Let's remove the main function and let's start creating our hello world application using Actix. Let's import from Actix Web, get post web app HTTP server responder and HTTP response. To create a route, for example, a get request at the URL just slash, you can just use an attribute. We create an asynchronous function called index that returns a responder. And for example, we return an HTTP response with the string hello world. We can also make a post request at slash echo, async function echo, with a string as a request body that returns the same request body. This is just as a test, of course. I want to show you a different way to create a controller. We don't need the attribute, and you can just write this asynchronous function. I'll show you the syntax for this specific route soon. And this returns, for example, just hey there. Let's create the main function. If you are used to the Express JavaScript framework, it's very similar to that. We have an asynchronous function that returns our result, and then HTTP server app new, and then both of the services index and echo, and we can also implement a route directly here. You can see dot route slash hey, and then web get to manual hello. We can then bind this to localhost port 8080 dot run dot await. We close the parentheses, and in 28 lines of code, we have our hello world with three routes. I really like the Actix syntax. Let's test it out. Cargo run. This usually takes a while the first time I run it. Let's test this application. Let's go on localhost 8080 and we get indeed hello world. If we go on a slash hey, we get hey there. This is just a different implementation of a similar function. To test the post request, I need a tool. For example, I'll use Postman. I can make a post request to localhost 8080 slash echo. In the request, I put a body in JSON format test 123, and I get as a response the same body, as you can see here on line 10. And that's it for this video. Let's visit the Actix Web website. I like the documentation. I think they used Docusaurus. Having a nice documentation is a sign of a healthy project. We can see here, for example, the architecture, and they go into details. Maybe I'll make more videos about this. Let me know in the comments what kind of videos you would like to see about Actix. Let's take a look at the GitHub project. We have almost 30,000 stars. I know that's just vanity metrics. For now, it seems like a very promising project. That's it for this video. I will make probably more videos, maybe a whole series about Actix. Let me know what kind of videos you would like me to make about Actix, and see you in the next one. Bye.